as we discuss in the non-conventional processes. Actually, we have the basic knowledge about the conventional processes only. That talk start with the lathe machine, milling machine, drilling machine, boring machine, grinding machine, etc. At where we are working and we are getting more accuracy. But sometimes we require some different kind of requirement from the industry. So on that time, how we have to tackle or how we have to use that kind of challenges, it can be fulfilled by these all eight processes. There are electrical discharge machining, we are considered as a EDM machining, electrochemical processing, we are considered as a ECM. After that, laser beam machining, it may be considered as a LBM machining. After that, we are talk about the electro beam machining, it is considered as a EBM machining. Then plasma arc cutting, ultrasonic machining, water jet machining, and abrasive jet machining. See, already we, if we just see these processes, then we understand that there are different kind of energy like ultrasonic, plasma, laser, and water jet. Talk about abrasive and electrical. So these are the basic energy. We can also include chemical and discharge process. So some energy process, as I discussed earlier, that it may divide based on the energy, based on different kind of processes, and based on the different kind of nature. So based on this way, it may divide or it may classify the class non-conventional energy. First, the need of for non-conventional machining process, as I discussed earlier, that why we require this non-conventional processing. Traditional machining process, as we know, that material removal by machining means such a chip forming, abrasion or microchip chipping process are too much higher. Okay, if we talk about the traditional machining. Same way, advanced machining process, where we have to utilize chemical, electrical, and high energy beam. The following cannot be done by traditional process. कौन-कौन सी process नहीं हो सकती? Workpiece, if it may be strength and hardness is very high, more than 400 HB, on that time difficult to cut that or hard, difficult to it may be give any kind of erosion, or we can say cut the metal. So on that time we are not prefer the lathe or that kind of traditional processes. Workpiece material is comparatively brittle, like glass. It's a good example that if we are use the glass or heat treated alloy or ceramics, on that time we are not prefer the conventional machining. Same way, workpiece is too slender or flexible. Flexible means it look like a rubber, or the shape may be more flexible. And slender means it, the shape length is higher and the diameter is comparatively smaller. On that time, that kind of part, complex part, complex geometry is there. On that time, we are not prefer the traditional machining. Hard to clamp, it means awkward shape is there, part shape is complex, long and small hole, very long hole is there and very small hole is there. Special surface and dimension tolerance require. Suppose sometime we require the very special requirement which are not fulfilled by the either we can say about the lathe machine or milling machine or CNC lathe or CNC milling machines, and then we are go for these all processes, or then we require the non-traditional, non-conventional machining process. As I discussed earlier, same way we have to classify the non-traditional machining processes in some basic way. The non-traditional machining methods are classified.
Sir, Vinod. Sir, 400 HB એટલે HB નો મતલબ શું થાય?
Hardness.
Hardness. Okay.
The non-traditional machining methods are classified according to the major energy source. As I already discussed that, here they are use some thermal means temperature, they may use electricity, they may use chemical energy, and they may use mechanical energy. Mostly we are divide all the processes in thermal energy methods, इलेक्ट्रोकेमिकल एनर्जी मेथड, केमिकल एनर्जी मेथड एंड मैकेनिकल, मोस्टली टेम्परेचर, इलेक्ट्रिकल, केमिकल एंड मैकेनिकल आर द बेसिक प्रोसेस वेयर वी आर डिस्कस बेस्ड ऑन एनर्जी सोर्स पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट, एज आई डिस्कस थर्मल मेथड्स ऑन दैट टाइम. In this method, the thermal energy is employed to melt and vaporize the tiny particle of work material by concentrating the heat energy on a small area of the workpiece. Okay, suppose we have a small area, and on that small area, suppose small area means it may not be 2 centimeter, it may not be in centimeter or millimeter. It may be up to a smallest area. We can say that 2 mm or 1 mm, we have to finish in that way, okay, or we have to prepare awkward key shape. So on that time it's not easy with the conventional process. So on that time we prefer that heat particle, some melting particle are vaporized, and due to that it may be directly focused on one point, due to that it may be directly melted. So based on thermal energy methods, it may divide in EDM, LBM, PAM, EBM and IBM. I think initially we are not discussed. Okay, already we discussed the plasma. So these are the basic 5 methods which involve in thermal energy. Means यहाँ पे क्या होगा? With the help of melt or vaporize tiny particle can melt the material. Okay, with the help of laser, with the help of electricity, with the help of plasma, with the help of electron, and with the help of ion beam, we are just directly focus on one point, and we just melt that required part, and we are getting the required surface. After that, electrochemical energy method, as we discussed earlier, it may divide based on the energy. So this is the second, that is electrochemical energy method, where these methods involve electrolyte, means anode cathode is there, anodic dissolution of the workpiece. All the methods we discuss after end of the classification in electrochemical machining, electrochemical grinding, electrochemical honing, electrochemical deburring. Okay, in this, if we talk about this part, then in our syllabus ECM is there. Why only one process? Because remaining 3 processes are already based on the principle of ECM, like anode and cathode is there. Okay, so if only one process we are understand, then remaining 3 are near to same. Okay, only functions are different. We already know that the difference between grinding, honing and deburring. So based on the first process, remaining 3 process only functions are different, but the principle are the same. Third one, chemical energy method. These methods involve control etching of the workpiece material in contact with a chemical solution. Okay, chemical machining method, that we discuss later. Then last, mechanical energy method. In this method, the material is principally removed by mechanical erosion of the workpiece, like the ultrasonic machining process, abrasive jet machining and water jet machining. Okay, these are the basic processes, and these are the basic classification where we are classify all the non-traditional processes. After end of these processes, we are start one by one process.